for the semi-final. We are underway. Who will go to the grand final for the first time? We're about to find out as they come back into Mari. And also over the top, it's Miller. Speaking of Miller, there he is again. Jersey number 10. They call him the giant of the forwards. Look out for him today to be destructive. That's the 40 meter line. Giving back away now to Mulalili. Makes it to the halfway line. Here's De Silva, picking in between the fullback and the winger on this occasion. Fagalili drifting across field, but Waga is in there along with Mulalili. Taken down here 15 meters out from their own goal line. Now here's the first penalty. First penalty of the semi-final. Boys from Patrician Brothers shoot this in the touch. A good kick. A 30 meter gain. What a chance now early on in the semi-final. The boys from Fairfield. This is Ilavalu. Always handy, isn't he? That's Miller. Explosive power, the big man. Always 100% intensity. There's Aachi. Coming back to the prop now in Mari. Talk about his big engine. He plays big minutes. Houlihan taking matters into his own possession. He's taken down here 10 meters out. A chance here now for Patrician Brothers to attack. Daniels offloads it. They need a quick pass. Great tackle there on El Hazem. Danger not gone. They work the left-hand side of the field. Too big, too strong, and just too good. Chaddy Daniels, that's how you do it. 4-0. After 2 minutes, here on the Daily Telegraph scoreboard. First attacking raid, opening points here in the semi-final. And of course that came off the penalty. Beautiful kick in the touch. And then Chaddy Daniel. We spoke about him in the pre-game. How lethal he has been this year. He's living up to all expectations. So the kick now from their 5-8 in Taj Coulihan. He's been on song, hasn't he, with the conversions of the crowd. The Patrician Brothers Fairfield. Round of applause as they come back to the halfway line and form a huddle. Well, here's Coulihan now from right out on the touchline. You can see he's a left boot striker of the footy. He'll be looking to bring this one back around. Can he do it? He's bringing it back around. It looks good. He's got it. What a kick from the touchline. Coulihan. When you're on, you're on. And Patrician Brothers, they're certainly on after 4 minutes of this one. And welcome back. You're watching the Daily Telegraph's live and exclusive coverage of semi-final football. And Chaddy Daniel, speaking of him, here he is with the football in his possession. Makes the tackle there of Leander Akaga. Taken down here, center of the field. They wanted an explosive start. And look at this defense. And Tuivasa. Welcome to semi-final football. Don't you love this time of the year? That's Myers. He takes the play to the 40 metre line. Inside the 40 now, backer comes to Chatty Daniels. He's under a little bit of pressure. Here's Craig. Did well. Get that footy back into his possession. Before he takes play from his home side back out towards the halfway line. Here's Lulili. Being picked up and driven back into his own side of halfway. Here from Jordan Miller. Zukuru, dangerous. Taken down here. 25 metres out. They work the right-hand side of the park. Looking dangerous again, aren't they? Two of a V. What can he do? That's where they are. A crowd getting behind them on the left tackle. Liakakaga. He's not going anywhere. Changeover. Tremendous defence by Patrician Brothers. Right on their own goal line. In front of about 200 or 300 that have come down on the bus from the school. And isn't it great to have just to have NRL schoolboy footy back after a hiatus, of course, of a few years thanks to the COVID. A full year. Just the names of rugby league, they just keep on producing from this competition, spanning more than almost a 40 years now. And isn't it fantastic that we now call our NRL Schoolboys Cup under the late Peter Mulholland, the great man in the game of rugby league, great recruiter, great coach, great mind. His passion, of course, was recruitment. Just having a look at the interchange benches, looks like Nemerapi is about to come onto the field here for Patrician Brothers of, Westfield. Still happening. We're just waiting for the recommencement of play here. If you just clicked onto our coverage, folks, what a try it was to Chatty Daniels. Not afraid to take matters into his own hands, is he? But Pekala comes onto the field. And we're broadcasting from the grandstand here this afternoon. And the mums and the dads, the grandparents, they're all in here in big numbers. Crowd getting behind Fairfield. I think you'll find they've got the ascendancy, not just on the scoreboard, but with the support here today. Bagalili now out towards the 20 metre line. That's Myers. Now that's a little bit too high for our official. With Bailey Myers. Comes off the back fence, doesn't he, all day long. That won't change in the semi-final. The kicks are good. Right on the 40. Here's Ilavalu. Three in the tackle. Over the top there was De Silva. Here's Miller. That's his fifth touch in 8 minutes of footy. Ayachi out the back door. They're looking dangerous here. Here's Lolahia. Taken into the turf here by Pigaculia. As the drums look to encourage Patrician Brothers. Are they about to go after their second try here? Semi-final number one. Myers out the back. Daniels offloads. Is Alhazm. He's brought down on the last. Leading by 6 points to nil on our semi-final scoreboard. Daniels runs, kicks, chases. Where is he for the tackle? Well, he says, no, I won't bother about putting in the tackle. I've done enough. I'll leave that out there for Ilavalu. And now Myers assisting. And tackle number two here, right underneath their own sticks here. As Westfield try and get out of their own danger side of the field, don't they? Looking to encourage movement through the middle. They get here by Funaluda. They've done tremendously well to come back to the 40-meter line and beyond. Jaddy Daniels in there again with the headgear. Last play. Up it goes. Bargalele up the back. What about the take? Under pressure. And he eats it up. Daniels. Is Lee. Strong. Determined. He's got speed to burn. So back away to Myers. Tui Vardy wrestles him. Here's Murray now. Quick go forward. Miller. Off the back fence. He would love nothing more than the semi-final try. There's Ayachi. Dishes it across the field. Bola here. And it is a changeover. It was the last tackle of Patrician Brothers. As Westfield Sports High come back away with it now. 10 metres out from their own goal line here on a... on a glorious day for semi-final football here at Campbelltown Sports Stadium. Two big games coming your way here on the Daily Telegraph. A spot in the 2022 Peter Mulholland Cup Grand Final. Now this will help them over halfway with the penalty. Identifying which side of the field they'll shoot this in the touch over here on the commentary side. So down by six. And it's Alagi. He's within 30 metres. I would love nothing more than to demonstrate their prowess here. The drum start. That's De Silva. Talagi out the back door. Lulalia still going. He's brought down 10 out. Patrician Brothers back on their own goal line here. Talagi offloads. Lulalia, he's within 5 metres. Here come Westfield. They're close. They're charging towards the post. Funaluda stopping them by a metre. That's De Silva on the last. They'll need a kick. Will they throw it? What's their last play option? They're going to chance their arm and chance their power. Can they get there? I think they're held up. No try. Well, they were in two minds, weren't they? Whether to go for the kick or go for the try. They went for the chocolates, but unfortunately it didn't come off for them. And Patrician Brothers will take the tap here, 10 metres out from their own goal line. Well, you talk about defence this time of the year in rugby league. A perfect example of that right there. As they try to steady the ship here into Ulalili. That's Lola here. That's his third touch in 12 minutes of football. Alhazm. is Murray. So it's the last play here as Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. Taj goes high. Luke probably will have his time over if he could. Well, that's pressure, isn't it? Semi-final pressure here in the Peter Mulholland Cup. Only 17 years of age, of course. He's getting the support from his teammates. Saying it's early days yet, don't worry about it. We'll try and defend it. But you can't allow Patrician Brothers sniffing opportunity 10 out. They'll make you pay. And will they make Westfield pay once more for the second time here? Daniels offload. Dilavalu goes to the line. He's going to be thrown to the touch. Well, there you go. Great defense here by Westfield. Great stuff. As we see Jordan Miller coming from the field here for Patrician Brothers after a massive input in the first 15 minutes of footy. Taken down here right in the middle of the park. Don't forget, folks, on grand final day, we're going to have multiple cameras right around the ground. Big production day. On grand final day, we're going to bring out all the cameras. Now, speaking of bringing everything out, here they are, 42 metres out from the opposition goal line. Tulagi now. He's trying to put his head in the frame. He's got a penalty for his efforts. Myers put his arm in the frame. The Kodak moment just went against Myers. So there's the kick in the touch. Take it in the tap and rolling forward. Here's Waga. Holt will just take the tap. He does that. That's Tuivati. That's De Silva. That's Pritchard. There's Luke offloading it. Too big, too strong. Sukuru. 6-4, thanks to the Daily Telegraph. Solomon Sukuru. What a finals campaign. What an athlete. What a teenager. What a future. He's been doing it not just in this game, has he? He's been doing it for the entire season of Peter Mulholland Cup. And he's not going to stop today. And don't forget about it, folks. You'll be able to watch all the highlights and read all about this one. Thanks to the Daily Telegraph. In the hours after this one, plenty of moments so far. What's the story angle after 10 minutes? Well, grunt, determination and willingness from both sides of halfway. Semi-final footy. A big shout out to everybody taking our coverage as well back at Westfield Sports High School. I know there's a big contingent of years in the auditorium. A big shout out to principals and all the PE teachers, the mums and dads, and likewise at Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. Where would we be without volunteers in our great game of rugby league? Put it simply, we wouldn't have it at this level, at grassroots footy. So what a chance now for the conversion. 10 metres in from touch. Mr. Lock is up at 6-all. It's hanging up there. The crowd think he's missed it. I speak about the crowd from Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. I knew just looking at them, they were trying to put him off, and that they did. We've got a game, folks, 6-4. 12 minutes of football remaining in the first half. here at Campbelltown. And of course, the Daily Telegraph, as we head into NRL finals footy, the back end of the NRL competition, you'll be able to read about it. Hard copy and the online digital version. All the sports journalists, as we gear up for an NRL grand final. This time of the year, we're gearing up for the Schoolboys Cup grand final next week. What a game that's going to be. Who will get there? Two question marks at the moment. Two teams will drop out of the competition by 3 o'clock this afternoon. Who will prevail? Who will hang up the boots? There's Waka. They go for a dig from dummy half. There's space here. More than space to Silva. Becker comes to Lulia. Can he get there? He's still going. Oh, he's right on the chalk. Tremendous defense again by Patrician Brothers. And we speak about bringing the crowds back. The crowds are back just because of the tremendous athleticism this year. We're just looking around the ground, folks. I'd say a crowd into the vicinity of maybe 1,000 to 2,000 people here today, just off camera, of course. But you can just hear the roar and the deafening sound effects and the drums coming through our special effects. Now, this is what it's all about. Look at that tackle. Where's the drummer now? He needs to beat it to the beat of the thump. Here's Lola here. Don't you love this? A bit of razzle dazzle. The circus is in town. Just pure football. Just outside the 40 metre line. Here's Craig underneath it. Didwell. Wasn't an easy catch. He drifts across the park into Funaluta. Oh, Luke again. Gee, give him the touch. He'll turn it into gold. He's picked up plenty of gold coins with the tries, haven't he, this year? As we see a tiny knock on, and they're not happy here. Westfields, they're absolutely filthy. Being consoled here, of course, by Ilaga Gaga. Also Daniel Waga. So changeover, we'll have the scrum, of course, 40 metres out. Patrician Brothers Fairfield goal line. Chaddy Daniels picking up the first try, of course, of the afternoon for Fairfield. Patrician Brothers, the third minute of the match. You hear the penalty, folks. The referee here says, Luga Gartak, come back here. Penalty was given for the shoulder. Now this is a dangerous part of the match. Could well be a turning point here. As Patrician Brothers look to dominate possession. That's Ilavalu again. Always a genuine running threat, isn't he? Here's Matt Alhazen. Taken sideways there. Away again to the right. Magalili offloads. Lola here pushes away from one. But now three push into him. Finally taken one-on-one here by Mapusua. Given back away this time to Funaluta. Angles it towards the post. Big numbers to the left. They're spread from the 10-meter line back to the 30. Is that a sign of something to come? Alhazen He's on his haunches, 2 meters out. Last tackle now for Patrician Brothers. They go to the left. Here's Daniels. He'll go himself. Now there's a try in the corner. Corey Lee. It was brewing. Now it's frothing. Try time. 10-4 on the Daily Telegraph scoreboard. Beautiful work. Speed to burn. That was an absolute acrobatic try, if you've ever seen one. It looked easy, but how hard was it? Yeah, Corey Lee. Being congratulated by the faithful that have come down from Patrician Brothers. It looks like here too, folks, I'm just looking to the touchline and Jordan Miller. I would have to say, probably one of the biggest forwards going around in the NRL Schoolboys Cup. I'd say it'd be close, nearly 7 foot. Just getting a few stats at the moment. 110 kilos, you know. Pretty big. You wouldn't want to be on the back end of that. You wouldn't want to meet him in a, you know, a back lane, would you? In Fairfield on a Saturday night. You'd be running for your life. Well, I know I would. Here's Taj from the touchline. He's running. He's kicking. Sensational. He's brought his boots today. It's a ripper. What a conversion. He just keeps on producing. He's got to be up there with the goal kicker of the year. I'm just looking around the NRL commentary box. We might have to start doing the 3-2s and 1s. He's got to be up there. Well, it's all about making segments up, isn't it, here on NRL Schoolboys. The producers, of course, back at the Daily Telegraph. The content flowing, just like the tries here. To Patrician Brothers. Oh, what an opening start. Free-flowing footy. This is what it's all about. Hope you're enjoying this, folks. We're taking our coverage. Here's Miller. Take it down here, 40 metres away. Now Taj hangs this in between the fullback and the winger. And Mapasua, he says, boys, I won't even play at this one. I'll just see this go over the touchline. I'll just go over and grab the ball when it hits the fence. Westfield now with the recommencement. Absolutely. Just over 4 minutes remaining in the first half of footy. As the drums. Well, it's making an impact, I think. To the beat of the drums goes the beat of the lost ball. Now this will absolutely not please their coach in Troy Whedon. If Patrician Brothers can put on more points leading into the break. 8 points the margin right now. But any more will not please their coach. As Daniels sets it in. Luga Gilata offloads. Taj with the footy. Steps, weaves, goes himself. Oh, he's the little pest, isn't he? And I mean that. Back away now this time. Here's Miller. Turns it to the right. They barge their way close. Funaluda. I think he's got there. No. He's held up.
held up.
But the danger remains for Westfield as the attack comes now. Alhazem taken down here, right on the 10 meter line. Buga Galata offloads it back to Miller. He's offloading, is he? Gee, he looked to pop it, didn't he? He'll play the ball. It's the last tackle now. What's their last play option? Back to Daniels. Here's a chance to the right-hand side of the park. Lola here. He offloads the football. And Muli Araga, he scores in the corner. Right on the stroke. Right on the stroke of half-time. Well, they've gone coast to coast. Beautiful work. And we just spoke about Troy Whedon. He didn't expect them to surrender the footy, Westfield, but Patrician Brothers, they've pounced. And the Dynamite winger goes over. Noah Funa. That's him. Goes in the corner. Well done, Funa. Yeah, of course, Muli Araga. I think he pulled his hamstring, didn't he, in the warm-up before the game. So that was a bit of a late decision now coming from the touchline. Yeah, so just to confirm, you know what, Funa has scored the try, playing out there on the right wing, the Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. But you don't miss much with, do you? I mean, as far as Muli Araga goes, he's a great finisher and a great scorer. But you take him out of the side, don't you, boys, and you put in Noah Funa, you don't miss much. And over he goes for his first try in the finals of 2022. Just over 40 seconds remaining. From the sideline, looks all right. Oh, it's just to the right-hand side of the post, folks. So what a first half of football for Patrician Brothers. They've turned their chances into gold. 4 tries in 30 minutes of footy. As Westfield. The siren hasn't gone yet. The drums beating to the tackle again. Time for Silva was in there. Back to Miller. The siren's about to go, folks. There it is. What a first half of football. The Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. Can they go on with it, folks? Talon De Silva gets his other way. Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. For a strong start, no doubt, in their first couple of tackles. Their first set of 6. That was Myers. What a first half this man continues to have. Jordan Miller. I know there's a lot of talent scouts here at Campbelltown this afternoon. Casting an eye over a plenty. Taj finding Luke Lilalai. And I know he's very pivotal in offloading the football. A 3 in there. They're back out to the halfway line here. And Westfield looking to assert their dominance around the ruck. Here's De Silva. He certainly is willing. Straight there into Taj. We're down by 12. Given back away from Pritchard. Good short ball. Here's to Largy. Last play. It's going to be a turnover. A turnover on the last. Right on the chalk of the Trishan brothers. Trishan brothers, faithful. Clawed that. Their boys come back and wave it now. Trying desperately to go beyond the 20. Good run from the back fence. There's Daniel. You know, he picked up that the first try in the second minute of the match. They've pretty much gone on from it as well. Pika Kalala. Laying down around the play the ball area there. The referee says, that's okay. I won't be penalising that. Here's Miller. That's the 40-metre line. They try to put the foot to the accelerator. Here's Junior. What a run from the back. Goes the fifth and the last. Bolahia goes behind him. And Funa, who was the try scorer late in that first half of footy, couldn't quite do anything with it there. So it's an easy turnover here as Westfield find themselves playing it back. As you can see from our Daily Telegraph cameras, this is where we are with Sukuru, just short of the halfway line. The silver again. Ulili, quick play the ball, needed. The silver, offloads. Kalagi, we go forward here. Back to Pritchard. Sebastian Pikakala needs to stay in the field of play. He's lost the ball. Well, he was looking around for support. He knew he was going to end up over the touchline. As Funaluta now comes away with it, right on their own 40-metre line. Taj dishes across. Here's Junior again. Into Minnow. And Kitty. There's Myers. Makes Patrician Brothers down to the 40-metre line. Miller offloads the footy. Daniels does well, chiming in. Ilavalu, now they put the foot to the accelerator. Here's Lee, taken down on the last tackle. A chance now for Patrician Brothers. Daniels, Chip, Chase, can they get it? They're going to be pushed into the end goal. Are they? Are they? That's the question mark. And the answer is, yes they are. We're going to have a goal line dropout from underneath the sticks. Was that man again? Chad Daniels taking matters into his own hands. Went for that little diff. Chip and Chase. So we're back underway. Schoolboy Rugby League. It started back in 1975. And you're watching the premier competition of schoolboy footy. To name a few stars that have come out of this, Ryan Adams, Reynolds, Champion. As they go for a dig from dummy half again, referee says, boys, just go back and have another crack. Exactly what they do here. But Miller will play it. Going to the beat of the drums. Taj is with it. 10 metres out from the opposition's line. We've got time off here. We'll stop the clock. Hurting that tackle there. Trying to identify who was over the top. I think it was Heathy Pritchard. Yeah. Probably one of the smallest on the field. Westfield, but gee, you can absolutely hit. And don't forget, folks, at 2 o'clock today, we've got our second semi-final. Hill Sports High will go around against Erindale College of Canberra. That's coming your way from 2 o'clock. Of course, both winners will play in the decider. So here's Myers. Bugagata. Finding Miller. Gee, he deserves a try. Can he get there? He's on the last. Lower here wants it to go to the right. They go away from him. He finds Daniels. Daniels, pivotal. Changeover, 10 metres out from their own line. Well, Westfield again. They're hanging in, aren't they? Just over 23 minutes of footy remaining. You're listening to the live stream. Watching the live stream right around Australia. Let us know on the Daily Telegraph Twitter world where you're tuning in, watching our coverage today. Helen's just saying she's tuning in from Hurstville. Hello, Helen. Take it down here, just short of the halfway line. There goes that kick downfield. It's away from Junior. He's got to go back there and collect it. Did well. Fingertip control. Nearby. The live wire from the back. And Dennis is from Dapto. Before he goes to the Dapto races tonight. Big night out in Dapto. Supporting Patrician Brothers. He's on a winner already, and it's only 12 o'clock. Just short of the 40-meter line. And a big hello to Matt from Maitland, in the heartland of Maitland Pumpkin Pickers, in Newcastle Rugby League territory. So that's the reach of NRL Schoolboys Football on the live stream, anywhere at any given time. Good take of the bike. Here's Luke. Ulili. Taken down here just outside the 20. So we've got a game of footy. Keep your messages coming in throughout the next 2 hours here on the Daily Telegraph. We'll get to as many as we can leading into grand final day. Just short of the halfway line by a couple of metres. Now I tell you what, we've got another coupling in from Shell Harbour here as we see the pass comes from, they're locked forward, still going. Well, how good's this? Ola Lapu, barging his way down to the 30. Give it back in out of Pritchard, on it comes. Here's Mapistua again on the last, he was held. Referee just saying, boys, go back and play the footy here. Well, there's Pikacala, last tackle now, they've got an overlap to the right, it's just a matter of putting it together, here's Wagga, he offloads it, that's a try to Westfield, number 5, Willie Craig, what a great leader, what an even better finisher in our great game of rugby league, Campbelltown Sports Ground comes alive. NRL Schoolboys semi-final 1 is alive and well. Well, that silenced the drums for a minute or two as we stand by for the kick from right out on the touchline for Talon De Silva. Well, Will Craig, it was just a big spread of the footy. Great hands. And then William Craig, the 17-year-old, putting Westfield back within eight here. Got a bumper crowd in here at Campbelltown Sports Ground. We're broadcasting from the grandstand. Holds about 3,500 people here, I think. I'll just have a look. Yeah, 3,500. And I'd say it's at 75% capacity to this stand. That's why the schools have had to go around the concourse. Here's the kick from the touchline. It's a beauty. What a kick. We've got a game of football. Stay with us. Semi-final number one. It's heating up. How crafty is he? The goal kicker in Talon De Silva. He's brought his boots with him. He was telling me a story about his boots actually last week. I'll get to that when we can. He loves the bright yellow fluoros. He's had them all his rugby league career. He wouldn't get rid of them. And why not when you're kicking like that? Taken down here just short of their own 30-meter line is Minnow. Look at this defense pushing them back towards their own 30-meter line. There's Pritchard. This space to the left. It's a matter of executing it. Here they go. Pikakawa. Oh, he's close. He's still going. Pikakawa. Oh, the referee said go back and play it. Well, the referee, respect of course, but he thought he wasn't held. The crowd thought he wasn't held. Now they charge to the 30-meter line. It is De Silva again. How quickly can games have changed in schoolboys footy? Here's De Largie with the football. 6 points they trail. Here's the kick in towards the end goal area. Awkward bounce, can they get there? Oh, it's another awkward bounce. It's an awkward bounce for Patrician Brothers, but it's a favourable bounce for Westfield. They've got bang, bang. Two tries, 2 minutes. I think it's Willie Craig again. He's picked up his double. Willie Craig single-handedly is putting Westfield Sports High back into the semi-final. Well, Willie Craig, the thief in the night, the thief in daylight, turning it on and turning on the dial to put them back within two. Well, we talk about pressure kicks in footy. We're looking over there to the western, to the eastern side of the field, to the Campbelltown Sports Stadium. And Talon De Silva. They don't come much bigger than this in teenage years of footy. What a kick. It's a pressure kick. He needs to bang this one. He kicks it. It's coming back around, but just to the right-hand side. But he says to his side, don't worry. There's still plenty of time left, fellas. There's still 15 minutes of football remaining here at Campbelltown. Oh, what a ripping contest. This has had absolutely everything. Semi-final football in all its glory. As Taj had to place it on the halfway line. We want to kick the leather out of this one. He does exactly that. A lot of hanging time, which allows the defense to come through there on to Avadi. That's where we are, folks, right on the 20-meter line. Navui now the Myers. As the drums again start to intensify and echo across the stadium. There's 2 points in it. Ulili, quick play the ball. Here they come again. Here they do come again. What a run from the halfway line down to the 30. It's the last tackle. They need a kick. Here it comes. The chasers are coming through. Where's Pikkakala? Pikkakala's coming through. Takes the tackle. But there we go. Slaps all around here for Westfield Sports High. Yeah, so this is a moment. It's semi-final football for them to give one tremendous shot at Patrician Brothers goal line. Heath Pritchard, the general, puts it in. Napasua offering it back there to Pritchard for another, putting it at the scrum base. So they're down by two. Here's Mapasua. He's dangerous. He's strong. Henry Gatlayer. He slides over, does he? He's brought down a meter away from the goal line. It's on the ground. It needs to be scooped up. Who wants to scoop it up? Now it comes back to Minnow. So it's still on. De Silva standing in the tackle here right on the 10-meter line. What great tension around Campbelltown Stadium. It comes back away to Pritchard. He steps. He goes himself. Oh, he's put away by Miller. Here come Westfield. They work the right. They skip. They offload. Rialata within 2 meters. De Silva switches it back. Ulalili offloads it. They're close, but they're not going to get there. Tremendous defense from Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. How good was that? That was very incredible stuff. And Westfield down 16-6 at halftime last week against St. Dominic's. And we know what happened there, don't we? They won 28-16. Just getting that from our Daily Telegraph producer. We've brought out the big games, the production team in full swing here today, and let us know where you're watching our coverage from, because what a cracker this is going to be, folks. With 12 minutes remaining of football, the first half. Sarah saying she is on the edge of her seat in the kitchen watching this on the big screen. And that's the great thing about digital, that you can cast onto your plasma. Doesn't matter where it is. So fantastic to have your company. This is what it's all about, bringing the game into your lounge room. And we do that thanks to the Daily Telegraph. We're on the last tackle now, folks, just outside the 40-meter line. They'll need to kick it, and they do. Talalungi. It's high, not much distance, but it allows to bounce. Junior's gone away to collect it. He looks up, and there's the welcoming reception there. Who else? Leah Tataga, just short of the halfway line. Now they scoot from dummy half. If anyone's going to carve you through the middle, could well be this man, Heath Pritchard. Almost out there with the biggest heart. Here's the elusive Lua Levy. Coming into it, isn't he? He's put a foot wrong at the back. Been a remarkable one-on-one performance between the fullbacks. Pagalili and Lalili. Here he is again. Damaging. Down to the 10-meter line. Down by two. Back to Pritchard. Out the back door. There's a chance now. Mapasua. Oh, he can't get there. Well, there you go again. Patrician Brothers of Fairfield. If they go on to win it, it's going to be their defense it has stopped. Westfield from getting across. Now they put the foot to the accelerator. Oh, the referee has given a penalty against the run of play. Oh dear, it was pushed in the back. What a relief. We're going to get it back here. With just over 10 nail-biting minutes remaining, folks. A cracker of a semi-final. And that's just about to heat up once more. Here's Tuivasa standing in the tackle. Now he's on his knees. Now he'll play it. De Silva, short. Sakuru, can he get it down? Now he's held up. How much more defense can Patrician Brothers withstand? Liam Nkaga, he's with the footy. This is desperation. Nualili, has he put it across the short? No. Plays it back to the right-hand side again. Right on the goal line. It's the last tackle. Trailing by two. What a game of football. It's saved again. No, they've lost it. That's a knock on. Listen to the crowd that have come here from Westfield. They're going to get another crack. Incredible football. Oh, how good's this? We're looking around the grandstand, which is at 70% capacity. Everybody's on the edge of their seats. This is brilliant football. Schoolboys football at its best. As we head to the grand final next week, who wants to be there? Even Stevens at the moment. Patrician Brothers hanging on by the scruff of their neck. 2 points, 16-14. But you can just sense Westfield, they're damaging. Here they go! Mapasua! He puts one leg into the grand final and two legs over the try line to go to the front by an extra two. Well, Patrician Brothers, how much more could they have prevailed? Westfield Sports High School gone to the front. What a cracking game. What a cracking try. What a cracking final series. Callum De Silva has the opportunity, folks. 10 metres in from touch. And 15 to the left-hand side of the post. Roy Mapasua, well done. Just look at the size of him for a centre. Well built, plenty of time in the gymnasium. Going places. 5 minutes remaining. Here's De Silva, a face of concentration. A hush goes around the ground. And just to the right-hand side. But no change here on the Daily Telegraph scoreboard. You're with Peter Jolly here at Campbelltown. Semi-final game number one. With 5 minutes remaining, Westfield Sports High lead now by 18-16. 1 week out from the grand final. Now who's got the footy? Let's keep an eye who has come up with it. I don't think it's De Silva. Silva's gone without it. And Jordan Miller, the tallest out there in the forwards, has come up with a tremendous take to give his side another chance. Will we talk about the pendulum in the game of rugby league? It's swinging here. Muga Kataka. He's within 2 metres. There's 4 minutes remaining. There's Archie finding Daniels. Daniels! On his back. About a metre away from the goal line. From one end of the field to the other. Back to Myers. He's on the last. They need a kick to the right-hand side. The jersey's off, but they still kick. There's that kick. There's the chase. It's too deep. Well, there you go. There's a moment in rugby league. Take the jersey off, but still put in the kick. Now, Westfield's come back away with it here, folks. 40 metres out from their own goal line. And Jenny Daniels has been told by the NRL officials to put your jersey back on. There's a changeover. There's a changeover. They've gone without it. The try scorer in Mapusua is Funaluda. Matas delivers. Miller tucks it under his arm. This will bring a penalty. Now, what do you do? Do you go for two, or do you keep the pressure on? Now, the call will come from the touchline. Just looking down to their coaching staff. They're barking into the walkie-talkie. So we've got time off here. The dangerous, dangerous tackle. Referee just having a chat there to Ulili. So this is the moment in the game where decisions have to be made. And tough ones, in fact. But they've got the possession, haven't they? They've got the urgency behind them. Do they take the tap? They do. Well, that's a team of confidence. That's Patrician Brothers of Fairfield for you. Why two when four's on the line? Here's Funaluda. He brushed away from one. He's still going, Funaluda. Taken down here right on the goal line. Riga Gagata. He charges. He's short by a metre. Now the referee has said, you didn't get there, and now, of course, well, hold on, we've got a penalty here. We've got a penalty. Now, it just took my eyes off the screen. So he's given away. Hands there. So they're going to go for goal here. So there we go. They're looking at the clock with 2 minutes remaining here. This to lock us up at 18 all, and possibly, do we go to extra time? Well, it's on the cards. We could well be going to extra time. So the moment falling here. Here for Taj. The youngster, with 1 minute remaining, can he do it? He's done it. We're locked up, 18 all here on the Campbelltown Sports Ground scoreboard, brought to you by the Daily Telegraph. I think the whole school's caught the last bus down to the field. Thousands in here. Oh, how good is this? So strap the seatbelt on. Buckle up. This kick out on the full. It's gone out on the full. Well, there wasn't much in it. A a whisker of paint. But it doesn't matter if it's 20 metres over or a whisker. It results in a penalty here to the halfway line. They avoid Miller. Oladipo. Are they thinking field goal? Who do they go to? Here's the big fella in Jordan Miller. Here's Myers. 28 seconds remaining in semi-final number one, and we're locked up at 18 all. Is Junior, he offloads it. Lolohia, he offloads it. Back to Junior. Junior, he's still going, Junior. What a run. Finished off here right on the 10-meter line. What a game of semi-final football. Here's Miller, angling it towards the post. We've got to go for it now. It's now or it's never. 5 seconds remaining in the match. Here it comes. Taj, he kicks them. He kicks them into the grand final. What a moment in the history of Schoolboys Rugby League. Celebrations for Patrician Brothers. Heartache for Westfields. What a moment. What a victory. What a celebration. Rugby League, how good is it? They're off to the grand final. After the siren, Taj has kicked them into the grand final next week. Wow, how good was that? That is what schoolboys football is all about. And we've seen it here today.